With the SendPulse online course platform, you can create courses of any format: video lessons, audio lessons, text lessons, add files, and a final test to confirm successful completion of the course. We'll look at how to create a course on your domain, add lessons and materials using the drag-and-drop lesson builder, set up course options, invite students and instructors, and create a certificate of completion. Go to the EDU section and click Create Your First Course. Before you create any course, you will see the welcome screen. If you have previously created some courses, click Add Course in the menu on the left. Click New Course. Enter the course name. The name of the course will be displayed in the list of courses in your account, on the site that allows you to enroll in your course, and on certificates of completion. The course URL is a unique link where your students can find the landing page that allows to enroll in the course and get access to lessons in their accounts. Select the second subdomain of the course address. The SendPulse.academy and SendPulse.online domains are available on the free plan as second-level subdomains. To connect your own domain, switch to a paid plan. After creating the course, you will need to connect the domain in the Sites, Site Settings section in the General tab. You will then be able to select the connected domain in the course settings. Enter the first subdomain of the course address. When creating your next course, you can select previously added domains and create new course pages using them or create courses using new domains. Enter the URL of the page with the name of the course in the second field. Click Save and Add. The course will be successfully created and you will be redirected to the course management page. Under the name of the lesson, click Add Lesson. Using the drag-and-drop lesson builder, you can create lessons, sections, and tests for each section. To create a lesson, you can add the following drag-and-drop builder elements. Text, used to add a text block to the page. Gallery, used to add multimedia elements to the page: picture, image, carousel, and video. Audio, used to upload audio content. File, used to upload other downloadable materials. Select a panel element and drag it to the workspace for further customization. To add the next lesson, click on the top left menu, and below the list of lessons, click Add Lesson. You can create a section on the course management page or using the builder. To create a section using the builder, click on the top left menu, and below the list of lessons, click on the arrow and select Add Section. Edit the title and add a description. You can create a test to assess the knowledge and skills your students acquired during the course. To create a test using the builder, click on the top left menu, and below the list of lessons, click on the arrow and select Add Test. Enter a name for the test. Click on the text of the first question and answer options to edit them. You can add answer options and mark the correct answer on the right. You can also drag and drop additional elements and diversify your page using the left panel. The page that allows to enroll in the course and the student's account is automatically generated using the default style. You can change its content by adding a title, description, and course cover. The page will also display the names of instructors. The course preview is displayed in the list of courses in the student's account. Go to the Course Settings tab and upload or select an image for the course preview. The course cover is displayed on the course registration page. Upload or select a course cover image. Enter a course description, who the course is for, and what skills students can gain after taking it. You can configure the following settings that determine how students will be trained. Course completion format determines whether the course is lifetime or scheduled. Course cost determines whether the course is free or paid. Course order determines the order in which each lesson is presented to the student, linear or nonlinear. Course conditions determines the criteria by which the course is considered completed by a student, completed all lessons, completed all lessons and passed the test, or just passed the test. Create a certificate to confirm that the student has successfully completed your course according to the selected criteria. Go to the EDU section in the Certificates tab. Customize the style and content of the certificate. Choose the color and format of the text, add pictures, and allow to display some additional information. Click Create, enter a name, and assign a certificate of completion to the course. You can also disable certificate issuance or select a different one in the course settings. By default, a course has one instructor, the account owner who created the course. You can add more instructors on a paid plan. To add an instructor, invite the user to your account. Then, in the Overview tab under the Instructors section, click icon Add Instructor. Select the invited user and add an avatar. You can add students manually via your personal account. They can also enroll in the course on their own via the course website. To add students manually, go to the Overview tab and under the Students section, click Add. Click the desired tab to select contacts to add, manually by list, via mailing list, or one at a time. You can also add a tag to download contacts. To get access to the course self-enrollment page, go to the course and copy the link. Once you've set up your lessons, test, and course enrollment page, click Start to launch the course. Please note that once you launch a course, you will not be able to change the format, cost, or address of your course. Remember to also publish the course registration page. Please note that lessons will be available to students if they are already registered and that the course is live even if you have unpublished the registration site. If you have set up a free course, then every student who confirms the enrollment in your course will be able to immediately start the lessons. If your course is paid and time limited, then the student will be able to access the lessons only from the start date till the end date after having paid for the course. You can check the attendance and conversion rates your course registration page brings in the Statistics tab in the Sites section. Since the site has only one page, and it's the main menu, the information will only be provided for one page at a time. To view your course progress and student performance, go to the EDU section, Overview tab.